Hey guys, Casey here. Tomorrow is our last episode for the season of ACRONYM. And before you skip through the video, I know you got lots going on. Wait to the end of this one. There's something worth it at the end. It's not long. Anyways, tomorrow being the finale of season one, we're talking all things British Columbia. We have an awesome guest tomorrow, one of our oldest friends, Dan Mangan, who you may have heard of over the years. Will be on with us to talk about BC and what he's been up to and how he's been handling this whole thing. And like I said, it will be our last episode just for this season. We'll probably pick it up again, but we actually have real shows coming up this summer, which is exciting and different. It's going to be odd. We haven't played in over a year, obviously, together, so it'll be exciting. There'll be lots coming with regards to announcements and stuff. We have the tour in the fall with the Dead South. It's all starting to come back, which is awesome. So this will be our season finale, and I'll get to the point here. I just wanted to say one of my picks for this last episode is Elliott Smith's song Needle in the Hay, which famously, I have to, little spoiler alert, if you haven't seen the Royal Tenenbaums, I'll spoil something here, but if you haven't seen that movie, you're not living right anyways. You need to figure it out and go watch that first before you do anything else. One of my favorite scenes, it's a very dark scene. It's Luke Wilson's suicide scene, very famous scene in the movie, shot with perfect lighting. It skips, it's very intense. And the song in the background while he's unfortunately committing suicide is this song, Elliott Smith's Needle in the Hay. It is, for an acoustic guitar and just a vocal, creates the most tense scene that I can think of in a movie in recent memory that I, when I think of intensity, it's that. I love his work. I love his, he's in the end of Good Will Hunting, one of the greatest songs, credit roll songs ever as well. And you know, if you like Elliott Smith, you probably deal with maybe depression issues or you can relate to them at least. A lot of us have issues like that on different degrees. So his music, if you know his life, obviously he struggled a lot with that stuff too, can be very sad. And I associate that song with intense sort of sadness. And then as I put the song on the list, I sort of went into a deep dive on it and I found this version of the song, which made me laugh out loud and will make me laugh anytime I feel shitty. I'm going to put this on. And you should too. If you're feeling bad, watch Kermit the Frog's version of Needle in the Hay. Here it is.
Hand on his arm, haystack charm around your neck, strung out and thin, calling some friend, trying to cash some check. He's acting dumb, that's what you've come to expect. Needle in the hay, needle in the hay, needle in the hay. Needle in the hay. He's wearing your clothes, head down to toes, a reaction to you. You say you know what he did, but you idiot kid, you don't have a clue. Sometimes they just get caught in the eye, you're pulling them through. Needle in the hay, needle in the hay, needle in the hay. now on the bus, nearly touching this dirty retreat. Falling out, six and pout, a dead sweat in my teeth. I'm gonna walk, 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 four more blocks, plus the one in my brain. Down, downstairs, to the man, he's gonna make it all okay. I can't beat myself, I can't beat myself, and I don't wanna talk. I'm taking a cure, so I can be quiet wherever I want. So leave me alone, you oughta be proud that I'm getting good marks. Needle in the hay, needle in the hay, needle in the hay. Needle in the hay.